Before we start the video, 99.2% of you guys are not sub. Please help me out by giving me a sub. Let's get right into the video. What is up? And I'm showing you a basically reviewing Pika Pika no Mi and all its moves and what they can be used for, especially in terms of PvP and in PvE. This is just a regular review, you know, telling you exactly about the fruit for you guys who don't have it and what you should use it depending on. Let's get started. Now, Pika Pika no Mi is a Lugia type of fruit, and it is a legendary rarity, and it is a 4% drop chance. Now, Pika no Mi has two passives, which is physical immunity, which is the Lugia bar. What Lugias do is they cannot get hurt by attacks that don't use Haki, as well as having light dash, which is another benefit of Pika Pika no Mi. Let's get into the moves. So the first move we have currently is Light Lunge. Now Light Lunge is basically where you pull out a light sword and you lunge forwards like that. This can be used as a guard break and can be used as a combo starter. Let's say you use Light Lunge like this, and then they're guard broken and you hit them with Black Leg and start a combo, and you do get damage that way. The second way, not in terms of PvP, is if you ever fall in water, you can use Light Lunge like this to get out of the water. Let's say I fall into the water like this, I can always click Light Lunge and then just get up using Light Lunge. So I'll show you. I'm currently in the water, I'm drowning, then I use Light Lunge in the water. I'm out and I get out of the water. That's the first move we have, that is Light Lunge. So the second move we have is Light Kick, the most used move in the terms of Pika users. So you get up in the air usually and you just down like that, and it has a pretty low cooldown, and you can hit people from pretty far away. So let's say I want to hit the door right there, I'm able to hit that. Let me show you how far it is. I'm gonna hit that tree right there by my cursor, and let's see if I'm able to hit it. I don't know if it hit, but it should. Let's just check that once again. Maybe I missed. And you can see how fast my cooldowns are. More or less, it can shoot pretty, and there's super low cooldown. So you can do that and see how far I shot. Exactly. That is the Light Kick. How can this be used in PvE? PvE wise, this is a very good move for aggroing users, because this doesn't insta kill. You can just aggro, you know, a bunch of mobs, you know, by hitting them far away. Like you see, you're in the air. You can hit mobs like there by the water, like this. That is, and you can get them to come at you. That's one purpose. The PvP purpose, I guess, just do some damage while fighting in the air, you know, just do this real quick, because this can be perfect block dodge, because it has a long wind up. You can see how people will instantly notice as you do the animation for Pika Kick. Next move. So the next move I have is Light Ray. Now this move is the reason Pika is so good at grinding, because I'll show you. Let's say a mob is at the ground, right? We can just do this, and we're hitting the mob from this distance while I'm not getting touched. As you can see, on the ground, I am doing a circle right now with the Pika Ray, and I'm burning the ground. And the thing is, if you have a lot of points in this, you can just kill Krakens, solo Krakens, solo Sea Beast, without them touching you. You just have to stand at a high place like this, and this can be done for dungeons. If you go to a certain corner in the dungeon in the Skypea Island, you can do this and you'll be able to, you know, kill every boss in the dungeon and most NPCs. This move is especially useful for PvE, but for PvP purposes, you get stuck, you can't move, and if you try to move, you can move, but it's very slow and you're most likely to get hit. And if you get hit, it cuts off the actual move, so it stops the actual attack. So this probably isn't very good for PvP, but it's amazing for PvE. Which is why it's a good farming fruit, which is why Pika is a good farm. Next move. So the next move is Light Flight. Now this is pretty self-explanatory. You basically fly in a straight line, you cannot turn. Light Flight is that simple, there's not much more to it. You just fly forward, so you cannot turn. How can this be used in PvP wise? I guess you can get close to your enemy. If it's far away, you just do this and then obviously hit them or whatever. That's all for PvP wise. Obviously you can fly, I mean, there's not much more. It does not have any like use in combat as per se, but it's useful for traveling distances, to close distances, to close gaps in PvP, gaps in general, anything. Yeah, next move. So next move we have is Mirror Kick. Now just point towards the area you want to go to, and it shoots a beam of light towards it, and we just It's basically a flying and then ending with a flying kick to the ground. So if you wanna go up there, you can just do that without flying there. You can just do that by, let's wait for a cooldown, do this right here. So you can see I go up there and I just hit from there. And it's pretty fast. Yeah, that's all for Murky. I guess it can be used for PvP wise if you wanna get to a certain area that's high up and maybe your fly is on cooldown. So for ultimate move or the last move, it's the Jewels of Light. Now this move is amazing for doing one big target bosses, and also for multiple small mobs, but for PvP this is horrendous because they can easily block this right here and they just get knocked back, so you won't hit every move. But if it's a big turtle like a Kraken or a Sea Beast, you'll more likely hit all the moves and you'll be killing them wherever, you're melting their HP very easily. For PvP I don't recommend this because, as I said, they can block it very easily and you know, they get knocked back, so they don't get all the damage and you just waste an ultimate just like that. But that's all for this review. Peace out.